Most of my audience is American, and since they don't get any news outside of their own country, it's like voluntarily living in North Korea, where the only news they get about other countries is how those other countries are bad. There's a good possibility that they didn't hear the story about the guy from Toronto who rented a van and drove it into a bunch of people, killing 10 and injuring 16. Shortly before this, he posted the following on Facebook. "The incel rebellion has already begun. We will overthrow all the Chads and Stacys. All hail the supreme gentleman, Elliot Roger." There's a lot to process here for the uninitiated, but the murder of 10 people has practically made the term incel more mainstream overnight for those who did hear this story. But here's the Cole/CliffNotes version. An incel is involuntarily celibate. That is to say, a virgin not by choice. They want to have sex, but no one will fuck them. Elliot Roger, the fucking little stain from California who wrote a manifesto and went on a murder spree, was also basically one of these. He referred to himself as the supreme gentleman, which he proved by shooting women instead of, you know, holding doors for them. So he's a martyr now for incels everywhere. Great. Chads and Stacys are normies. They are men and women who have sex like normal people. Now, did you know that there's a very simple way to stop this van attack before it started? Oh yes, you see, incels have offered their hot take on how this violence could have been avoided. If the Canadian government implemented a state-distributed girlfriend program, I guarantee these attacks would stop, says a self-described Christian anime gamer. So hopefully he knows he's going to hell for jerking off to Sakura games. Oh, and just to be sure they weren't trolling, I scrolled through this guy's Twitter feed. "God is angry at the West for letting women vote. Repeal the 19th Deus Vult." No, he's for real. He does believe that women should be property, handed out by the government as fuck toys for men. Someone else thought he was just some edgelord making a joke about vehicular manslaughter, and he replied, "Don't talk like you understand how incels feel. I am no longer one, but I am intelligent enough to have sympathy for them." Why is it always the dumbest fucking mouth breathers who brag about how smart they are? Society treats single men like trash and it needs to stop. The people in power, women, girls, they run the world, can change this, but they refuse to. Blood is on their hands. And their tampons. Women, if you just fuck some piece of shit who also likely felt the government should give you away like you're a free fleshlight, 10 people would still be alive. And these dudes can't understand why women don't want to spend any time with them, huh? I mean, they have such charming personalities. Well, here was a similar viewpoint that surfaced. This guy believes that incels have a legitimate grievance. They don't, we'll get to that, and proposes these societal changes. Number 1. Women are no longer allowed to wear makeup, i.e. falsely advertising their beauty, and hence stop them from banging guys above their league. This suggests guys won't fuck a girl out of their league, or that the league thing is really all that real. I've seen some pretty ugly dudes dating some really attractive women. I've seen ugly women dating attractive men. I've seen ugly people dating ugly people and attractive dating attractive. But anyway, no longer allowed to make a choice about their appearance. Already pretty insane. And it gets better. Women are only allowed to date men with equal sexual market value to them. State-mandated tests should be made, and everyone gets a sexual market value card, ranging from 1 out of 10 to 10 out of 10. Like an ID card. Like, you know, forcing people to have a number assigned to them. Normal behavior. How is your score determined? You didn't ask because this is lunacy? Well, they'll tell you. Every time a woman sleeps with a new man, she lose one. The number one, people who aren't as smart as I am, rank on her sexual market value card. By the way, this sounds like a McCafe punch card for a free coffee. Until she reached the lowest rank, 1 out of 10. In case you didn't know that 1 out of 10 was the lowest number on a 1 to 10 ranking. By the way, men don't lose a number this way. To be fair, they don't gain them this way either, as we find out in rule number 4. There's no rise through the ranks, other than through exercise. This guy's making the rules, so he clearly decided spelling wasn't a way to rise through the ranks. This very well thought out plan seems to be missing what levels you up, like how many squats do you have to do and how many miles do you have to put on the treadmill to increase your fuck number? And what if you're just ugly face-wise? I've seen some fit dudes and gals who had horrible faces, but I guess the kid from Mask could get like a 10 if he was ripped. But finally, we get to the most reasonable rule. Women with more than 9 sexual partners and single moms should be forced by the state to date and have sex with incels that can't get any women despite the above changes. Forced by the state to have sex with incels. So you could have skipped numbers 1 through 4, because this all just comes back to this nonsense where the government rounds up women for some sort of weird fascist fuckfest. This would deal with the problem, not the symptom. And this is the way we deal with everything from counter-piracy to counter-terrorism. Sorry, we deal with counter-piracy and counter-terrorism by forcing women to fuck them? Is that what was going on at Guantanamo? Or under this analogy, what, we give pirates a bunch of free games and we give terrorists a bunch of buildings to fly planes into? Now I'm just as shocked as you are that this insane rambling makes no sense, but here we are. But getting a bunch of shitheads with low self-esteem laid isn't the solution to a problem, because the problem is depression. I mean, this is the darker version of, oh, you wouldn't be such an asshole if you got laid. Surprise, I get laid, and I'm still a massive fucking asshole. Regular penile friction against vaginal walls has done nothing to solve my anger issues. So recently, I went to an incel forum and found a post titled, "Why are incel forums so addicting?" One person said, "I like being able to discuss factual things about reality, society, women, and race." What are those factual things? If you wear a dress that shows your legs off, you are inviting sexual contact. Legs are a sexual thing like an ass for men. So any woman wearing anything focusing on her legs is asking to get rammed by Chad Cock. Oh boy. What fucking year is this? First it was ankles, now we can see knees. Where will these teases stop? The dress might as well say, "Please have intercourse with me at your earliest convenience." But one of the comments, which I thought was the most reasonable one I could find here, said this. "It's a support group, and it has really helped." This is the thing. It is a support group, but it's supporting fucking insanity. Like a support group for drug addicts where they all just sit around going, "Fuck the world for not letting us use heroin every day. The state should give me heroin." And everyone else goes, "Yeah, great idea. Kill anyone who thinks we shouldn't get high all the time." It's the wrong kind of support, and it's no wonder that Reddit banned our incels. Going through this forum, there's a bunch of shit about people believing acid attacks are warranted, that quote, "all whores should be killed." These people shouldn't be grouping together. But they do need help, and sex wouldn't solve the problem. It would just help with a symptom. If they got laid, they might be happy for a brief moment in time, but they're depressed, they're mentally ill. And the cure isn't some girl to fuck. If you really think it is, go get a hooker. You got disposable income, right? I mean, you're certainly not spending it on dates. If you think you shouldn't have to pay for it, you're a piece of shit who thinks women should be given to you. You already likely believe you'd be paying for sex if you had to buy a girl dinner first, so just skip it and hand the girl the money. At least hookers make the choice to fuck people, unless they're part of a human trafficking ring. But again, if you believe that you should be issued a sex slave, you already don't have a moral issue with that. But it won't solve anything. Even with a girlfriend, you're still going to be depressed, because you are depressed. You are still going to feel alone. And while a support group of people going, "Don't worry, man, I can't get a girlfriend either. You're not weird, it happens to others too," would be great, that is not what this is. These incel forums are an echo chamber of blame for everything but themselves, and no one looking inward or saying, "You know what? Sex isn't that important anyway. I'll find other ways to fulfill my life." And maybe in doing so, they'd channel their energy into something better, maybe even become a better person, one that someone would actually want to spend time with. I get it. Society made you think sex is the greatest thing that you're missing out on, because sex sells, and you watched a bunch of teen movies that made it seem like sex is the most important thing in the world. Although every big modern movie now seems like it caters to people who can't get laid, but if you were truly as intelligent as you believe you are, you'd understand it's all fantasy, it's all marketing to make you want to buy a bunch of shit. This is about as compassionate as I will ever get. These people need help, for sure. They need therapy, probably medication, but I'm gonna guess they probably don't believe in that. After all, mental illness? Well, that's just stupid. Not like state-gifted women, the intelligent, sensible solution.